So there's a whole new breed of AI note takers, and they're called idea organizers. They've been around for a couple of years, but today I want to dive into three that I think are worth your attention, and mainly because they've got a new superpower of artificial intelligence. We're going to overview all of them, give you an idea of which one are worth looking at for you to check out. All of the apps that we mentioned will be included below if you're interested. So the first one on our list, in order of interest for me, is one called Sublime. Now, I actually initially got an idea of Sublime probably about 6 months ago, and I was quite interested in it because of the social element of it, that it quite, I guess the idea of bringing cards together in a community is quite a cool way of sharing thoughts, especially when it comes to your second brain. And I've seen concepts like Glasp work really well, which is another popular social network for that. And I thought it's sort of like, to some extent, a way to visually do that. So the application works with a Chrome extension, it works on web, and it also has a iOS application for capturing on the go. And the simple concept is you can create a new canvas or a collection, and you can start uploading items, or you can start capturing them on the desktop. You can right click on stuff and press add to Sublime. And then, for example, I captured this picture of a Ferrari earlier. You can organize them into collections for later. Now, the difference with this is, as I mentioned, is the social element. So this one here has been shared globally to everyone, and you can see that 257 people have liked it, saved it, and you can see that concept also has related concepts that people are sharing and capturing as part of their account. So in terms of a second brain and bringing ideas together, it's quite a cool concept because this could then stem into a concept of talking about the idea of reconciling things and obviously wanting to belong and have that as part of your sort of collections and be able to capture things. So it's that sort of ever expanding idea process. And as you can see, you can bring those into collections. Now you can also add notes to all of these images, which are sort of like captions, which give you a reference for later. You can create these collections. I've created one for Ferrari, and you can make them private too. Now what's nice is you can collect all the whole article if you want to, which is great for bringing ideas for later. Now, if I go back, you can also see that there is imports to Kindle and Readwise. And I believe they also do have an integration with Raycast, which allows you to quickly see stuff that you have captured in Sublime as part of that. Now you can go ahead and do things like shuffle across your account to bring ideas up. And you can use this canvas mode to basically bring ideas together. So this canvas mode is developed by TLG Draw. I think that's what they're called, Teal Draw. And the abilities are pretty basic in terms of what you can do. So you can bring these ideas together and start creating a very basic canvas to some extent. So that's the abilities for now. They also have a premium. I don't really know when the free runs out, to be honest, but you get unlimited cards as part of the premium, and more of the abilities are unlimited related cards. So I'll try and work out where the free plan is. I have not been able to find it. I am obviously in it, but I wanna work out what are the limits of adding cards and adding collections and things like that. So there's also a lifetime, which is $400, but there's premium, premium plus, and obviously you get more abilities in terms of privacy and collaboration and other such abilities. So this one was probably not top of my list in terms of the idea organizer. I think it's a nice concept. It's still very early days. I like their thesis behind the application in terms of like trying to build a second brain that's community focused. But in terms of it actually being a really robust AI note taker and things like that, I'm not sure it has those capabilities that I thought. For example, even the basic note taking that you can see here, it's really, really basic. There's not much to it. The AI powers really come when you look at this related card feature that allows you to essentially build out concepts and thoughts and saving them within the community. Today's video is brought to you by Zapier. Zapier are one of the leaders in AI automation. A little bit more about them later in this video. So the next application on my list is one called MyMind. And these guys use AI to essentially tag and organize all of your notes into one location. Now this is really cool because you can see it's got these things called mind tags. And also there's a TLDR attached to this, which helps summarize what is in the footage that you've got here. Now what I quite like about this application is how clean it is. The application works incredibly well on mobile, and it just works very, very well. You've got this lovely focus mode and you can see it zoom in. And one of their, I guess, priorities with this application is having something private and secure. So it is very much a paid application once you pass the 100 card limit in free, which does push you towards, obviously, you know, a more premium experience, if that makes sense. And the pricing starts a little bit steeper than most of the other apps on the market, probably closer to apps like Sublime. But you can see here, like features like the reader mode is something that's really attractive, but also locked under the premium. Now, there are loads of different small AI features that you can use as part of this, but it's a good application just to start searching and building up a base. For example, you can quickly see stuff that you have captured over a period of time, and it's probably one of the better, more reliable AI organizers on the market, one that I've tested over 3 or 4 years now. So well worth a look at if you're looking for something more robust and one that has well-known AI features, if that makes sense, ones that are practical and easy to use. So before we dive into number three, if you're struggling with finding the best note-taking app, you can download our free guide today. It's simple, easy, and it will land in your inbox, giving you a PDF guide about how to pick the best note-taking app with resources to follow as well. So check that out in the link in description. Did you know that over 1.3 million people use Zapier with AI? This can help you save time, optimize repetitive tasks, and get more done. Zapier helps you to create workflows and automation by building simple or complex workflows and connecting nearly 8,000 integrations. Zapier is one of the leaders in AI automation, and that's why over 3.4 million companies use Zapier to get things done. Get started today for free down in the link in the description. So the third application on my list is quite an interesting one. So I've checked out many of these type of applications before. I actually checked out one as part of this review called AI Notebook, and I thought, this is pretty all right. It's nothing special in terms of like capturing a YouTube video, bring up to summarize that. Well, this application is something that we've had on Tool Finder for a while and something that's been on my list for a while because I keep hearing echoes of people using it. And it's quite interesting. The way that I describe it is sort of a combination between Wikipedia and a notebook, and also with AI features. It's hard to explain what it actually is. So as you can see, I started to take some notes in here, and what you can do is capture a YouTube video, a news article, or PDF, whatever it is, and you can bring them into here. And what it will do is a little bit like these YouTube summary tools like Aitify. I reviewed them last on a Chrome extension video. I'll include that link below. But they essentially allow you to communicate with this notebook and you can chat with it. So for example, I could say, who won the race? And it'll give you a response using AI based on that. And as you can see the timestamp in which and what team won. Very happy with that result. But it goes a step further by turning anything that you've done into a quiz. Now, just to stop you there, this is obviously AI powered and uses probably ChatGPT. I haven't actually checked out which one they use, but you can see down here in the left-hand corner, you can see this is how many cards have used a certain feature before you need to upgrade. So there's 4 out of 10 cards. And I believe that the generations of quiz items and things like that inside of an existing card doesn't contribute to the AI power limit, but you're gonna hit 10 quite fast if you're using this quite aggressively. I'll share the premium pricings a little bit later, but it's quite cool because you can go onto this quiz and you can basically see which circuit did the have this, you know, which circuit did it happen on. And you can see there we go. So you can start to do yourself a quiz and you can use this peek feature to basically sort of cheat on the answer, if that makes sense. But what I quite like about it is you can go to review and basically see how and what you got correct. And you can also start a quiz on certain things. So I found this person here, poet, and you can basically get a quiz on that person. Now, this is why it's interesting, because I'm not somebody that sort of found that person, because it's definitely a lot smarter than me in terms of like beyond my abilities. But you can start to see when you've done a AI powered
card summary, you can start to see that these things appear. So you can see James Scott, author James Scott. If I click into them, you can see that this Wikipedia page is pulled in from Wikipedia as a person. So these tags appear and automatically organize for you. And if I were to say press expand up in the top right hand corner, what that will essentially do is bring that Wikipedia information and generate that person as part of my account. So I can start to see a relationship, see here, a relationship between anything that I've created and structured tags, which is quite cool. So I can now see, okay, James Scott is related. The backlink is Productive Disorder, which is one of Tiago's articles. So I can not only chat with the information, but I can also distill it quite interestingly, like break it down and connect things up, which is quite cool. Plus, when I added something like this in, it automatically tagged it as motorsport and sports. So it's quite interesting in terms of what it can actually do in function and form. Now, the premium is fairly reasonable. So I was expecting it to be maybe $12 to $15, but it's actually $10, which isn't too bad. They've got a feature called augmented browsing, which I haven't tried yet, but you get, I'm on the actual light plan at the moment, but there is a $7 pricing per year, which is actually just slightly more expensive than the yearly pricing of Eightfully. I can't believe I just reviewed that, I forgot the name. But there's another element to this is you can actually create your own journal entries, uploading PDFs, or just using their inbuilt notebook. And you can create a quiz from whatever you type away, or you can create a graph. So for example, in this case, if I go to the graph view, I can start to see the relationship between certain people and the accounts that I have. So I'm starting to build a graph view up. And I was expecting this application, mainly because it's got quite a lot going on, to be quite slow and not as fast with the AI side of stuff. Actually, it works quite fast, which is something because I review so many tools, I end up going, nah, this one isn't that good in terms of speed. And you can see the graph view separately and how all of your different notes connect up. Now, the graph view isn't like hideously interactive. So if you click into one, obviously it comes in, but like it won't allow you to do things like grab a little bit of your node and be able to connect them up. But nonetheless, I actually think it's a pretty good structure. You can also see here, you can go ahead and create the card. So you can choose whether you want a reader, a detailed summary, or just go and save stuff from your bookmarks bar, which is pretty cool, and upload a PDF or search online. You can also start with that empty note, which brings you to this view. And it's not an ugly view, in my opinion. It's just quite basic. And you can also see down here, looks like you get some money off as well, which is quite good. Let me show you the settings very briefly. So there's not too much in the settings, but largely you can get an email to summarize that. So this one is called Recall AI, and it looks pretty impressive, to be honest. I've played around with it. I've chucked a couple of things in that I thought would be quite difficult, and it did it quite well. So if you're looking for maybe a more of an idea organizer that you can write notes in as well, this one could be a good alternative to My Mind Alike. So that was today's overview of AI organizers. These ones are pretty decent. Obviously Sublime, still in its early days. My Mind, well established, reliable, and Recall, an interesting yet reliable newcomer to the space. So thank you so much for stopping by, everyone. Thank you very much for joining this video. If you did find it valuable and all of the solutions, you can find all of the apps below. Please do subscribe and like the video if you found it useful, and I'll see you all very soon, I'm sure. Cheerio for now.